Hello students, so the next type of coding is called as LempelZip coding. So where in the previous class we discussed about how to solve an arithmetic coding technique. So now here LempelZip coding also used for lossless data compression, and also one more advantage of this is it is going to reduce the storage capacity. So that means when you encode the data, so when you store it in the memory requirement for storing the data required will be less in the case of this LempelZip coding. That's why whenever the data storage has to be taken care, so this LempelZip coding will be applied for encoding of the characters. So now here these are the steps what we need to follow for performing this LempelZip coding. So where the first step is, it is accomplished by dividing the data into segments. That means whatever the character or the numbers which are given, so those are firstly it is divided into segments. So then after the data has been divided into segments, then these segments are the shortest sequence not encountered previously. That means the segments what you are going to divide, so that it should not be encountered previously. That means while division of the segments, the same segment should not be repeated anywhere else. So that is the meaning of this second point. Then we have the third step where all segments are retained as phrase. That means, so all the segments what we have done the segmentation, they are retained and they will be provided a position. Then the fourth one is we encode the phrase by prefix and the last bit. That means when after encoding, so we are going to retain the last bit and then that will be denoted by a prefix. And also while we perform this LempelZip coding, so we have to consider these important steps here. So where the symbol, so this is the null symbol, so where this is represented by 00 and the letter A by 0 and letter B by 1, and if we have used binary encoding, so then 1 will be represented as 1 and 0 by 0. So now let us look into an example of how to solve this LempelZip coding. So this is an example here. So consider the given sequence. So the sequence is this one. So where they have given a stream of characters here. So for this stream of characters you need to apply this LempelZip coding. Okay, so now the first step what we need to do is that, so we need to divide the whole string into segments. So let us divide these segments. So where first we'll start with the letter A. So A is not accomplished or it is not encountered previously, so A is segmented. Then we have next letter here is A, but A is encountered previously, so we will go for the next one AB. So this I can segment the second one. Then if we consider the next, so we have already encountered AB is already there, but ABB is not there. So ABBB. Then we have the next one, that is B. So B has not encountered previously, so I can write it as B. Then we have AB. So AB is already there. ABA is not there. So it is ABA. Then we have A, B, A, B is already there. A, B, A is here, but A, B is not there. So it is A, B, A, B. So this is one more segment. Then we have B. So B is already encountered. So B, B is not there. So this is one more segment. Then we have A, B. A, B is already there. A, B, B is also there, but ABBA is not there, so it is ABB as well as A. And the last is BB, so which is already repeated, So but since it is the last segment, so we'll consider it here and we will provide it by a position. So now this is how you are going to segment the given sequence. So you are done with the segmentation. So the next thing is that, so you need to provide some position. So what is the position, then the sequence, then the representation, that is numerical representation, then finally you have to represent in the digital code. Okay, so this is how we are going to construct the Lempel ZIF coding. So first we will be having the position, then the sequence, then we have numerical representation, so then we have the digital code. So here the position means how many segments we have divided. So we have divided into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So we have 1 first position, then we have 2, this is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and this is 9. So now first, what is the sequence? It is A and this is AB, A, B, B. So this is B and this is A, B, A and this is A, B, A, B. Then we have B and B and then we have A, B, B, A and the last one is B and B. See here, these two are same. Okay, so after writing the sequence we have to represent them in numerical representation. So where, when you are representing in numerical representation, so since here we need to encode, so we have to retain the last bit, last bit in the sense, so here we don't have anything before A, so we will be considering a null value and we'll retain the A letter. So then we have the second, so where this is the last bit, so that is B. So what is A? A's position is what? It is 1. So then we have here the last bit is B. What is AB? AB's position is what? It is 2. Then we have B. So in front of B we don't have anything, so insert a null character, then 5 and the last bit what we have written is B. So here retain the last bit as A. What is AB? AB is 2. Position of AB is 2. So then we have retain B. What is ABA? So ABA's position is 5. Then we have B. What is B? So B's position is 4. So then we have the last bit is A. What is ABB? So we have ABB here. It is 3. Then we have B and B. So what is B and B? So retain the last one. So this B is nothing but, so we have, so since B and B is already present here, so we will be representing it as 7. So since we don't have anything, so we will be inserting a null character. Okay. So next we have to represent in the form of digital code. So 5, so 5 is represented as 0, 0 and A is by 0. Then we have 1B, 1 in binary it is represented as 0, 1.
So what is B?
So B is represented by 1. Then we have 2. So 2 is represented as 1, 0.
B means it is 1.
Then we have once again 5. It is 0, 0.
What is B?
B is 1. Then we have 2 here. 2 means it is 1, 0. A means it is 0. Then we have 5. 5 means it is 1, 0, 1. What is B? So B is 1. Then we have 4. So it is 1, 0, 0. So B is 1. Then we have 3. So it is 3 means it is 1, 1. A means it is 0. So we have 7. So it is 1, 1, 1. 5 means it is 0, 0.
So this is the encoding. So that means,
so 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, then 1, 0, 1, 1, then 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0.
Okay.
So this is how we are going to
perform the coding using your Lempel-Ziff algorithm or Lempel-Ziff coding.
Okay.
Let us look into one more example with respect to this Lempel-Ziff coding. So that means, so this is the sequence what they have given. So for this sequence, you need to apply your Lempel-Ziff coding. So the first step what you need to do is that you need to perform the segmentation of the given sequence. So here the segmentation starts from here. So 1 means, so A1 has not encountered previously. So we'll consider 1 first, segment it. Then we have 1 and 1. So 1 is already encountered, but 1, 1 is not encountered. So it is 1, 1. Then we have next is 0. So 0 has not encountered previously. So it is 0. Then we have 1, 0. So 1, 0 has not encountered previously. So it is 1, 0. Then we have 1, 0, but 1, 0, 0 has not encountered. So it is 1, 0, 0. Then we have 0, 0 is there, but 0, 0 is not there. So it is 0, 0. Then we have 1 which is already encountered. So but we will consider it as 1. Okay, last 1. So now, so this is how you are going to perform the segmentation. So once you have done with the segmentation, so next what you need to represent, you need to represent their positions 5, 6 and 7. So construct the table. So first you need to write the position, then we have the sequence, then numerical representation, then we have the digital code. Okay, so here so position, this is the sequence, representation as well as the digital code. So where position, so this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then 7. So now what is the sequence? So sequence, it is 1, then we have 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, then we have 1, 0, 0, then we have 0, 0 and 1. So now numerical representation, so we have to retain the bit, that is the last bit 1. So since we don't have anything, represent by a null character. Then here it is 1. So what is 1's position here? So it is 1. Then we have 0. So since we don't have anything, represent by a null character. Then we have the last bit we have to return, so it is 0. So 1 is what? So 1's position is 1. Then we have to retain the last bit. So what is 10? So 10's position is what? It is 4. Then we have to retain the last bit 0. So 0 means it is in the third position. So then we have 1. Then we have 5. So what is? So we have to retain 1 and we have to represent it by 5. So where you can see here, so 1 and 7 are repeated. Okay. So then after performing this operation, so next, so instead of writing here 5 with 1, so here we have repeated 1 and 7, both are same here. So instead of writing 1, so here what I can do is that, so instead of, so what is 1 here? So 1 is present in the 7th position. So I am going to write it as 1 with a null character. Okay. So next we need to represent it with respect to the digital code. So 5 is represented as 00. So 1 by 1 only. So then 1 by 0, 1. Then 1 is 1. Then null character is 00. So 0 by 0 itself. So here it is 0. So this 1 is 0, 1. Then we have 0. So 4 is represented as 1, 0, 0. Then we have 0. So 3 is represented as 1, 1. Then we have 5. So it is 0, 0. So 1 by 1. So this is how we are going to encode the data. That is, we have 001, 011, 000, 010, 100, 110, 001. So this is the encoding what we are going to get for this particular sequence. Here we have repeated. So here we have the sequence, that is in the case of numerical representation. So 1 is being present, that means in the first position also we have 1 and in the 7th position also we have 1. So this I can represent as, so this is 1 as it is I have written. So the last bit I am going to represent it by a null character. So then this will be, your 1 will be 0, 1. And 5 is represented as 0, 0. So this is 0, 1, 0, 0. Okay. So the last bit, 1, what it is there. So we have retained that. Since we don't have anything to be represented after 1, so we are representing by a null character here. So where the value of null is 0, 0. So 1 value is 0, 1. So this is how we are going to perform the Lempel ZIF coding. So this completes the second module. Thank you.